Good morning and welcome to Morning Devotion. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for the opportunity to come into your presence this morning. We thank you, God, that you have gathered us again, as you always do every day, oh God, in not just giving us a brand new day to enjoy your goodness and your mercy, but also to see your glory today. And so, Father, we thank you for such an amazing day, and we pray that your presence be with us now and for the rest of today. In Jesus' name, amen. And now we will go into our worship with music.
Oh, I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. Oh, and I've seen many searching for answers far and wide, but I know we're all
Hallelujah.
For your mercy never failed me. In all my days, I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. Woo! 'Cause all my life you have been faithful. Woo! And all my life you have been so, so like no other. I know you as a father. I know you as a friend. And I have lived in the goodness of God. Let's do that one more time.
Amen. We thank the Lord for that wonderful time of worship and music. Right now, we are going to, today we do not have general prayers, so we will have our Bible readings. We have two readings today. The first reading is from the book of Proverbs 16, verse 1 to 9. And the second reading is Mark 16, verse 9 to 20. Our first reading, Proverbs 16, 1 to 9, will be read to us by Patrick, our brother Patrick. You're welcome.
Well, we're not hearing Patrick, so we have to go ahead.
Oh, Sister Lydia, you are muted.
I'm sorry. Thank you. Proverbs 16, verse 1 to 9 says, in the New King James Version, the preparations of the heart belongs to the Lord, but the answer of the tongue is from the Lord. Belongs to man, but the answer of the tongue is from the Lord. All the ways of a man are pure in his own eyes, but the Lord weighs the spirits. Commit your works to the Lord, and your thoughts will be established. The Lord has made all for himself. Yes, even the wicked for the day of doom. Everyone proud in heart is an abomination to the Lord. Though they join forces, none will go unpunished. In mercy and truth, atonement is provided for iniquity. And by the fear of the Lord, one departs from evil. When a man's ways please the Lord, he makes even his enemies to be at peace with him. Better is a little with righteousness than vast revenues without justice. A man's heart plans his ways, but the Lord directs his steps. Amen. And our second reading, Mark 16, 9 to 20, will be read by Sister Kehinde.
Sister Kehinde, are you with us?
Sorry, that morning. I'm reading from the NLT version. And I read, 9, after Jesus rose from the dead early on Sunday morning, the first person who saw him was Mary Magdalene, the woman from whom he had cast out 7 demons. She went to the disciples who were grieving and weeping and told them what had happened. But when she told them that Jesus was alive and she had seen him, they did not believe her. 12. Afterwards, he appeared in a different form to two of his followers who were walking from Jerusalem into the country. 13, they rushed back to tell the others, but no one believed them. Still, after he had appeared to the 11 disciples as they were eating together, he rebuked them from their stubborn unbelief, because they refused to believe those who had seen him after he had been raised from the dead. 15. And then he told them, go into all the world and preach the God's news to everyone. Anyone who believes and is baptized still will be saved, but anyone who refuses to believe will be condemned. These miraculous signs will accompany those who believe. They will cast out demons in my name, and they will speak in new languages. They will be able to handle snakes with safety, and if they drink anything poisonous, it will not hurt them. They will be able to place their hands on the sick, and will be healed. 19. When the Lord Jesus had finished talking to them, he was taken up into heavens and sat down in the place of honor at God's right hand. 20. And the disciples went everywhere and preached, and the Lord worked through them, confirming what he had said by many miraculous signs. May the Lord hear our reading in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you for the reading, Sister Kehinde. Now we will get ready to receive our charge from Pastor Tunji.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We thank God for another day in his presence. Before I go into the chat, let me just tell all of us again, please always pay attention, at least at the beginning of the program like this, to be checking your chats, because messages are sent, but sent as particularly as to reading the scriptures. And I can see that some people that the messages were sent to were just replying. And when we send it to you, a few minutes you don't reply, we send it to somebody else because we don't have the time to know whether he or she is still going to reply or not. So those of you who are replying late, the time has gone for today, another time for you. Okay, praise the Lord. Today, particularly this week, I want to bring a challenge to us. And in bringing that challenge to us, I want to put something in our hands that will help us, let me put it that way, in executing that challenge. This week, we are going to be concentrating in our charge all through the week on kingdom mandate of witnessing. The kingdom mandate of witnessing. And we have different brethren prepared for that. Last week, I said something significant as we were closing. When we're talking of kingdom service, that listen, when the Lord Jesus Christ was leaving this earth, there was one assignment he gave all of us. That if we are even going to be looking at kingdom service, that should be pretty much at the center of it all. And that is going to all the world and preach the gospel. That was his mandate to us, very clear. In fact, at the beginning of his ministry too, when he began to choose his disciples, he didn't confuse them with many things that he would do for them or do to them, or he needed them to do for him. There was no confusion at all. It was just one statement. Follow me and I will make you fishers of men. So both at the beginning of his ministry and at the end of that, it's the same. Follow me and I will make you fishers of men. When he was going, now pretty much saying, go ye into all the world and fish men for me. I mean, pretty much. So my brothers and sisters, this morning, this is it. At the center of our service in the kingdom of God is the preaching of the gospel to the lost. I pause for you to hear that. So if the preaching of the gospel is not in what you are doing, you are not in that service yet. I'm sorry. Hence this morning, by the Holy Ghost, I want to reinforce that message to us and charge us to do something about it, or to do the same about, I mean, this week. And the first thing in charging us on it is praying about it. And that is one of the significant, that's the significant place of prayer, because through prayer, you can affect things to come by praying about those things. Prayer always goes ahead. I want you to know something this morning. It's not only necessary, it's not only possible, but necessary for you and I to tap into the future. Prayer, that's what it is. Through prayer, we get God engaged in our future. We walk with God concerning his plans for our lives, concerning the affairs of our lives. And especially on my focus today, with these prayers that we're going to start praying today, you are getting God engaged concerning his plan of preaching the gospel for you. We call it prayer. We call it seeking the face of God. We call it communion with God. All that put together, the point is, that is where and how and where we draw strength. We're enlightened. Our eyes are opened in locating. We draw strength in doing the plan of God for our lives. Why? Because prayer processes the plan of God. It is said, as your prayer life increases, not only will your walk with God be affected positively, but God's plan for every area of your life will more effectively be brought forth. When you are engaged in that, you see brighter, you hear clearer. I love the way a man of God put it. He said, prayer is doing business with God. Prayer is doing business, or going into a business venture with God in processing his plans on earth. So I want to challenge us from today, this week, to join hands in partnership with the Holy Spirit, doing what you can, which enables God to do what he can also for you in your life. Prayer is always the catalyst that brings forth the ability of God on earth. We all know that. That's the first thing I'm trying to put in place, which we are going to pray today. You know, today we have more time in our personal prayer. That's why there is no general prayer on Mondays. So you are going to start that prayer even today, in taking the preaching mandate seriously and prayerfully. When you do it prayerfully, it will not just be a religious activity. It will be with real purpose, because in prayer, you take strength. In prayer, virtue is released, and then you are able to go. I hope we know, and this goes to all of us, that God is not coming down to share the gospel again with people. the church you are going, God is not coming down to begin to bring people to church. No, he gave us the mandate. And I see people go to one church and another, and we don't really have new people in this church. How many have you brought? It's easy to say, but how many have you yourself saying it brought? He gave us that mandate. That's our mandate. That's for us. He said, I will make you fishers of men. If I will ask you, I will say, how many have you fished? Oh, this church is not even growing. Great. How many have you brought? Because that's for us. Daily, weekly, monthly, that's for us. That's at the center of our kingdom service. And when we don't get engaged in it, we are missing out completely and foundationally on what God has for us to do. God must have somebody preach the gospel, invite them to church, and all that goes with it. Look at you, for example. God must have used somebody to share the gospel with you, the good news of salvation with you, whether in a church congregation or person to person. He must have used somebody. Whether it was a friend or a colleague or a family member or somebody you just met on the street, he must have used somebody. Regardless of who that person or persons, organization might be, now that you have received the gift of salvation yourself, it's now your turn to share it with others. You know, it's interesting, the word the Lord Jesus Christ used for us. He said, and you shall be my witnesses. A witness is somebody with a practical experience in the subject matter. He has saved you, go tell others what salvation is. Or go get others saved, you're a witness. A few people have asked me, so what do I say to them? I want to believe God this week as we go through the kingdom mandate, we'll hear more of that. I say, you are wasting your time, you are overthinking it. Go tell your story, you're a witness. As I've said, which we all know, we all as Christians are commanded, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. That's Mark 16:15. I believe this is the time to simply reach out to the lost around us and introduce the gospel to them. Some of us are doing it. Many, talking from experience now, are not even thinking it, not doing it. I know many of us see it as a big challenge, so difficult. So we just pass by them, we walk with them, we go around them, we live in the same neighborhood with them, we live in the same apartment complex with them. We just don't bring that to them, find it difficult. Well, that's why the call for prayer this morning. All those difficulties, all those challenges in doing it, bring it before the Lord. Lord, I want to do this. Help me. I want to be effective in this. Help me. I want to be productive in this. Lord, help me. Don't you remember the disciples too at first? Under great persecution, they prayed. Give us boldness because we are afraid. We don't know how to confront these people. We don't know how to go on before these people. How are we going to stand before these people? Prayed. That's what we want us to do. I want us to do this morning. They saw it. You are not the first. If you are afraid, I'm sure you don't like to use that word afraid. But you are not the first. They prayed. Give us boldness. And the Bible says, and the place where they were was shaken, and they were filled with the Holy Ghost, and they began to speak the word of God with boldness. Strength is coming to you this morning for this mandate. That's why we read two scriptures this morning. The first from Proverbs, and a lot is in that Proverbs. You can learn a lot in Proverbs. The first in Proverbs, the preparation of the heart is a man. So let me quickly say something about that. The preparation of the heart is a man, but the answer of the tongue is from the Lord. Of man are arrangements of the heart. Oh no, that one looks so well. The plans of the heart belongs to man. Yeah, you plan to, but the answer of the tongue is of the Lord. Prayer and preparation goes together. In prayer, you are preparing the way, and the answer will come from the Lord. So as you pray this morning, you know how you feel about witnessing. You know where your strengths and your weaknesses are. As you bring them before the Lord this morning, that's in preparation for what you are set to do this week. And I trust you, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of God himself, our Master, who mandated us, answer of strength, of boldness, of power will come from the Lord for you. As the Bible says, even if it's still in that same Proverbs 16, commit thy ways unto the Lord, put also that, and thy thoughts shall be established. Listen to me, this is no joking matter, and I've seen it in recent times that God is dealing with me on the subject of the kingdom. It's the center of it. Is the center of it, and it should be the center of your life and my life. So commit that process into God's hands. I tell you something this morning, as you pray sincerely because your heart is there, you want to do, God will go before you and make it happen for you. Remember, that's what the scripture says, when he put forth his own sheep, he goes before them. And when God goes before you, the journey will be great. Look at it, Proverbs 16, verse 9. A man's heart devises his ways. You are planning to do. Like you say, safety is prepared against the day of battle, for safety is of the Lord. A man's heart devises his way, but the Lord now begins to, this thing you want to do, that you have put in my hand, and you really want to do, I'll begin to help you. The Lord begins to direct his steps. Before you know it, it leads you where the harvest is ready. It leads you to the right places, the right people. It gives you the right inspiration for them. As you open up yourself before the Lord this morning concerning this assignment, I pray and I believe also that God will begin to direct your steps through it. So, I want your prayers this morning for this week to be focused on preparing yourself a vessel, prepared, ready, worthy of preaching the gospel. You know how to pray. You know what to pray. God will put the right words in your mouth. So that I put my words in this mouth. God will give you the right inspiration. Give you the boldness above everything. Please understand with me, God's people. It's our duty to share our faith on many fronts because, number one, God commanded us to do so. That's how you yourself got to be in Christ. If you truly love the Lord, like we claim, he says, if you love me, keep my commandments. And that's his commandment for us. It's a demonstration of our faith, of our true love for him. We share faith. Can't you see what is all around us these days? I came across a statistic last week that is damning, that for the first time in history, America is falling below 50% of churchgoers. And that should touch you. After COVID, it's falling below. Many are falling away. This is where God has positioned us. This is our location. They're not going to come because this is America. No, they are going to come because we go after them, getting them saved, bringing them before the law. It's our mission to save the lost, to go after them. There is no other name under heaven among men by which anybody will be saved. We have that name. We know that name. We have been saved by that name. So let's go give it to them. Sharing our faith. It's God's chosen method to tell all the people what Christ has done for us. The forgiveness of sin is brought us. The salvation is brought us. The knowledge of God is brought us. We are the only ones to do it. Angels will not do it. That is a mandate given to us. See the way Romans 10 puts it. How shall they call on him? If whoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Okay, we know that. But how shall they call on him? Call on him in whom they have not believed. How shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard? It is that hearing that is our mission. Telling them, getting them to hear of it. How shall they hear without a preacher? You and I are the preachers. How shall they preach? I said, if he said, we already said, go ye, he said. Go ye, he said. We are sent already. As I said earlier, in closing, I want your prayers this morning to be focused on preparing yourself a vessel worthy, ready, empowered for the preaching of the gospel. I know to make it easier, and some of us have been limited to bringing people, just go bring them to church. Well, they all go together. Pray this morning after this man. Starting with, Father, use me. Here I am, O God, use me. I make myself available to you. Fill me with your spirit and power. Clean me up. Make me worthy of this assignment. Prayers like, Father, give me the words. The right words to say. Guide my steps. Direct, like Paul said, the Lord himself direct our way unto you. Direct me to the right prayer, like, Lord, strengthen me with boldness. To be a powerful witness. I'm just trying to put this word so you can know what we're talking about when you start praying. Fill my mouth with right words. The Bible says, how possible are right words. That's where you meet somebody that looks as, you know, everything you feel like if you run away from this, but the right words, right? The Holy Spirit comes and you see that person break down in tears before you. You are wondering what's going on here. That's the power of the Spirit with right words that it puts in your mouth. Incisive words that penetrates the soul. Don't think it beyond you. The power of the Holy Spirit is over it this morning. Looking for who is worthy for this, who is calling for it, whose heart is right, crying to the heavens for it. I feel it heavy in my heart. That is our number one mission, the center of your life. And I'm laying out this challenge today by the Holy Ghost, that this week, that you must do. Don't take it lightly, my people. God is watching. So let's go before the Lord this morning. Oh, Riata, let's go before the Lord. Just call upon the Lord. Present yourself to him. Cry before him. Lord, strengthen me. In all manner of way you want to pray, because you know yourself. Help me to be fruitful this matter. Empower me to go this week. Let this week be a most memorable week for me in the preaching of the gospel. I'm available. Use me. Hallelujah. Let's go before the Lord right now. We'll be back together shortly. Just pray as you bring yourself before the Lord. We'll come back later. God bless you. Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. What a new week set before you, before us, to prove our faithfulness to our King, our loyalty to Him, our love to Him. It's not just about you. You are a citizen of this kingdom. There is what God expects of you. And I know you've presented yourself before the Lord again this morning. Pray to Him. Ask for His help. So this month, God will help you. This week, God will help you. As you go, know this one thing, that He has gone before you. He said, the Lord is He that goeth before you. As it goes before you, He levels the mountain, fills the valleys, makes the path straight, and you will return like they did with joy. See the effect so that you can continue to do it. It's a mandate from heaven. It's at the center of it all. So get going. And the Lord be with you. Get going. And the hand of the Lord manifests to you. Get going. And strength, the strength of God Himself, goes with you. Get going. Jesus is Lord. So this week the challenge is preach the gospel. Turning the path of many to His kingdom. Of course, the church is at the center of that operation again, and get them to church. And I tell you this, as you start doing, the wind blowing around you will change. You see it. Things will begin to turn around you. You will see it. Because he that beareth fruit, he purges to bear more, he says. And he's faithful to his words. So go. Get going. I can still hear that shouting in my spirit. Get going. This is your week. The strength of God is giving you this week. The peace of God continually attends to you this week. In the name of Jesus. Let's have a word of blessing from Pastor Jesus this morning.
Amen. Amen. We give glory, honor, and praise unto the name of the living God. We just bless the Lord for such a wonderful time in His presence. That is the Great Commission. That is the Great Commission. Let us go and make witnesses of the Lord. Let us go and become fishers of men. If you want to be great, be part of the Great Commission. If you want God to make you great, then commission yourself into the Great Commission. As you get into the Great Commission, you will be great. Father, this morning, I pray for your blessings upon your children here at this platform. Father, as your children have come to begin their day and their work with you, Father, be with them, O God. Let your mighty hand pave the way before them, O God. Lord, loosen every resistance in their ways this day and open the heavens, O God, and bring your mighty blessings upon them this week. Let your children celebrate you this week in Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. As we know, this program runs Monday through Friday, 5 a.m. to 6 a.m. Mountain Time. And we are encouraged to go and invite people to come. Let us share the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Be blessed. Have a blessed week in Jesus' name. Amen.